Hello and Namaste everyone, welcome to my channel SigmaX. Today, we are learning about alternating current through a resistor, an inductor and a capacitor separately. In my next video, I will teach you about LCR circuit. If you don't want to miss that video, then hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon so you can get notification when I upload it. Now, let's start our journey with the definition of alternating current. As the name suggests, alternating current is a current whose magnitude changes with time and direction reverses periodically. An alternating current results when a sinusoidal EMF E equals to inner sine omega t is applied in a circuit. If R be the resistance in a circuit, then according to Ohm's law, the instantaneous value of alternating current at any time t is given by I equals to inner sine omega t, where I naught equals to E naught divided by R is the maximum value, or you can say peak value or amplitude of alternating current. The angular frequency omega is also known as driving frequency and is equal to 2 pi divided by T or 2 pi F, where T is the time period and F is the frequency of alternating current or EMF. The alternating current and EMF can also be represented graphically with x-axis representing time and y-axis representing the magnitude of instantaneous EMF or current. Note that the value and nature of alternating current depends on elements like resistor, inductor, and capacitor in a circuit. Therefore, at first, let's find the nature of alternating current through a resistor only. If an AC source is connected to resistors only, then such a circuit is known as purely resistive circuit. So let us consider a purely resistive circuit with an AC source E connected to a resistance R. We know that the applied alternating EMF is given by E equals to E naught sine omega t. Let it be equation 1. If I be the current in the circuit at any instant of time t, then the potential difference across the resistor equals to IR. Applying Kirchhoff's law, we get E equals to IR or I equals to E divided by R. Putting the value of E from equation 1, we get I equals to E naught sine omega t divided by R, which gives us I equals to I naught sine omega t. Let it be equation 2. Here, I naught equals to E naught divided by R is the amplitude or peak value of alternating current. From this equation, we can infer that resistance to AC is equal to the resistance to DC. That means the behavior of resistance R in DC is same as in AC. If we compare equation 1 and equation 2, we find that E and I are in phase. Therefore, in purely resistive circuit, the current and EMF are in same phase as shown in this graph. Do you know there is another method to represent the phase relationship between alternating current and alternating EMF? It is called vector diagram or more oftenly, phasor diagram. In a phasor diagram, the amplitude of EMF or current is represented by a line called phasor with an arrowhead at one end and another end attached to the point of origin. Similarly, the phase is represented by an angle made with a reference vector or x-axis in anticlockwise direction. Remember, the anticlockwise rotation of the vector is considered to be a positive rotation. Likewise, a clockwise rotation is considered to be negative rotation. Also, you can choose any vector, either EMF or current, as a reference vector. In this tutorial, I will choose current as my reference vector. Draw the reference vector always towards x-axis, whereas draw another vector according to its phase. Since in purely resistive circuit, current and EMF are in phase, its phasor diagram looks like this. In this phasor diagram, you can see that current and EMF are in same direction, that is, the angle between them is 0 degree, which means there is no phase difference between them. Now, let's find the nature of alternating current through inductor only. Such a circuit where an AC source is connected to inductors only is called purely inductive circuit. So let us consider a purely inductive circuit with an AC source E connected to an idle inductor of inductance L. We know that the applied alternating EMF is given by E equals to E naught sine omega t. Let it be equation 1. If I be the current in the circuit at any instant of time t, then the induced EMF across the inductor equals to minus L times di divided by dt. Here, negative sign indicates that the induced EMF opposes the growth of current in the circuit. As you can see, there is no potential drop across the circuit. The sum of applied EMF and induced EMF must be zero. That is, E plus minus L times di divided by dt equals to zero, or di equals to E divided by L times dt. Putting the value of E from equation 1, we get di equals to E naught sin omega t divided by L times dt. Now, to find the instantaneous current, integrating both sides, we get I equals to integration of E naught divided by L times sin omega t times dt. Since E naught divided by L is a constant, we can write I equals to E naught divided by L times integration of sin omega t times dt. As we know that the integration of sin ax with respect to x is minus cos ax divided by x, similarly, the integration of sin omega t with respect to t will be minus cos omega t divided by omega. Hence, instantaneous current I equals to E naught divided by L omega times minus cos omega t, which can also be written as I equals to E naught divided by L omega sin omega t minus pi by 2. So that I equals to I naught times sin omega t minus pi by 2. Let it be equation 2. Here, I naught equals to E naught divided by L omega is the amplitude or peak value of alternating current. If we compare I naught equals to E naught divided by L omega with Ohm's law equation, that is current equals to voltage divided by resistance, then we find that L omega has the dimension of resistance. Therefore, it is known as inductive reactance and is represented by XL. Hence, the inductive reactance is the effective opposition offered by an inductor to the flow of current in the circuit. Thus, XL equals to omega L or 2 pi f times L, where f is the frequency of an AC circuit. We know that for DC circuit, frequency f equals to 0, which implies XL equals to 0. That means a pure inductor offers 0 resistance to DC. Also, since inductive reactance is directly proportional to the frequency of AC circuit, higher the frequency of AC, more is the inductive reactance and vice versa. Note that inductive reactance is measured in Ohm. Now, to find the phase difference between current and EMF in purely inductive circuit, comparing equation 1 and equation 2, we get the current I lags behind the EMF E by a phase angle of 90 degree. In other words, voltage leads the current by phase angle of 90 degree as shown in this graph. In phasor diagram, it is represented like this. Here, you can see that EMF E makes an angle of plus 90 degree with reference vector current I, which means there is the phase difference of plus 90 between EMF E and current I. Now, let's find the nature of alternating current through capacitor only. Such a circuit where an AC source is connected to capacitors only is called purely capacitive circuit. So let us consider a purely capacitive circuit with an AC source E connected to a capacitor of capacitance C. We know that the applied alternating EMF across the capacitor is given by E equals to E naught sin omega t. Let it be equation 1. If Q be the charge in the capacitor at any instant of time t, then the potential difference V across the capacitor equals to Q divided by C. As you can see, there is no potential drop across the circuit. The applied EMF must be equal to the potential difference across the capacitor. That is, E equals to Q divided by C, or Q equals to C times E. Putting the value of E from equation 1, we get Q equals to C times E naught sin omega t. Now, to find the instantaneous current, we should take derivative on both sides with respect to time t. Therefore, taking derivative on both sides with respect to t, we get current I equals to derivative of C times E naught sin omega t with respect to t. Since C times E naught is a constant and the derivative of sin omega t with respect to t is omega times cos omega t, we can write I equals to C times E naught omega cos omega t, which can also be written as I equals to E naught divided by 1 divided by omega C times sin omega t plus pi by 2, so that I equals to I naught sin omega t plus pi by 2. Let it be equation 2. Here, I naught equals to E naught divided by 1 divided by omega C is the amplitude or peak value of alternating current. If we compare I naught equals to E naught divided by 1 divided by omega C with Ohm's law equation, that is current equals to voltage divided by resistance, then we find that 1 by omega C has the dimension of resistance. Therefore, it is known as capacitive reactance and is denoted by XC. Hence, the capacitive reactance is the effective opposition offered by a capacitor to the flow of current in the circuit. Thus, XC equals to 1 divided by omega C or 1 divided by 2 pi F times C, where F is the frequency of an AC circuit. As I have said earlier, for DC circuit, frequency F equals to 0, which implies XC equals to infinity. That means a capacitor offers infinite resistance to DC. In other words, it blocks DC current. Also, since capacitive reactance is inversely proportional to the frequency of an AC circuit, higher the frequency of AC, less is the capacitive reactance, and vice versa. Note that capacitive reactance is also measured in ohm. Now, to find the phase difference between current and EMF in purely capacitive circuit, comparing equation 1 and equation 2, we get the current leads the EMF E by a phase angle of 90 degrees. In other words, voltage lags behind the current by phase angle of 90 degrees as shown in this graph. In phasor diagram, it is represented like this. Here, you can see that EMF E makes an angle of minus 90 degrees with reference vector current I, which means that there is the phase difference of minus 90 degrees between EMF E and current I. Finally, we have come to the end of this video. I hope by watching this tutorial, all of you have understood much more about an AC circuit with a resistor, an inductor, and a capacitor separately. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, then please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. And also, don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get notification when I upload a new video. I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye-bye.